Oscar Wilde said that it's easy to make history, but it is difficult to write it, and even more difficult to picturize it. Now, a writer duo called Alex Rutherford, basically Michael Preston and Diana Preston, wrote a six-part series on the rise and fall of Mughal Empire. You would have read it. I tried reading it, but it's quite lengthy, so I'm just in the middle of it. And the first part has already been made into a web series, and that is what you have just seen in the trailer. And I have the director, and I have the actors of the film. Very, very welcome, Shabana ji, Kunal ji, and Mitachra. How are you?
Thank you. Shukriya.
Very well, thank you.
So let me start with Shabana ji. Shabana ji, it's a very tricky thing to recreate history. Now, the gentleman that we're talking about, Muhammad Zahiruddin Babur, he was... Obviously, he wrote Babarnama, he wrote it in Turkish of that era, which got extinct in 1920s. Khana different tha, kapre different the. I heard the press conference when you said that we wanted to get away with the diamonds and the golds and try to make, give it a tribal look, which actually was the look of the historical times. You are the senior most member right now in the cast, and you've had a huge body of experience with you, where you have actually worked with Indian and international projects. What did you bring to the table? What actually you did tell the cast out of your experience about making historicals?
मैं सिर्फ मैंने क्या किया उसके बारे में कह सकती हूँ, and that was basically building a character for whom we don't have that much. Reference. And even when pictorially you're trying to look for Essan Dolat, there's just one photograph, one painting actually, from where you can construct her. But the interesting thing that Mitakshra kept telling me is that this is based on the book, and although it is historical, it is a construct. We all have to remember that it's a construct. And why is it a construct? Because the writer and the director and the producer have chosen to tell a story, a tale that has a lot of drama, that has a lot of intrigue, that has chance for a lot of spectacle that you can see. So has chosen that and then has to be true to the story they have chosen to make. So that was my very clear parameters within which I was working. For me, she's very interesting because she's very layered. She has lots of layers to her. And she's a very strong, very feisty woman who can take decisions quickly. And so she takes this decision, this 14-year-old boy, she decides that it's time to crown him, which is obviously quite dramatic on its own. So it's full of all of that that you expect in a series of this kind.
Absolutely. And Mitachra, you are an FTII graduate. You have been an assistant director for the longest time. You actually have been a protege of Sanjay Leela Bhansali. And in your filmmaking, I can actually see Sanjay Leela Bhansali as well, with those dark shots and, you know, the mystique on screen. Tell me the same question that I asked her, one that everybody would like to know, is it... It says fictional. The book says fictional. How much is truth in the series and how much is fiction? One, matlab hum isko kitna seriously le, viewers isko kitna seriously le. Because obviously, when we talk about history, you have to be very, very, very meticulous about how you're presenting it. And secondly, I really like the way Shabana ji also said in the press conference that ab jaise humne, we have grown up watching Mughal-e-Azam and Jodha Akbar, where everything was shiny and beautiful and the dialogues were very, very, ye phool nahi, ye जख्म नहीं फूल है दुर्जन फूलों का मुरझाना बहार की रुसवाई है वेरी वेरी ड्रामेटिक डायलॉग्स नाउ हियर यू केप्ट इट सटल आई सॉ दैट यू केप्ट इट क्वाइट सटल दो वी आर टॉकिंग ऑफ बाबर नॉट जस्ट अकबर जो कि और पहले आए थे ही इज अ मैन हु फाउंडेड द एंटायर मुगल डायनेस्टी हाउ वाज योर एक्सपीरियंस एंड व्हाट आर द थिंग्स यू वर वेरी केयरफुल अबाउट
सो जैसे मैम ने कहा एंड लाइक यू ऑल्सो सेड Mughal-e-Azam and Jodha Akbar were taken from chapters in history, but they are both love stories. They're both fictional tales. They tell you a fictional tale. Now, we don't know exactly how much of that actually happened, how much did not happen. So we are not out to retell history. That is there for everyone to read about, right? We were just being honest to the book that we were basing this on. And like ma'am said, ek 14 saal ke bacche ki journey, uske relationships. For me, modern history, it's a human story. That's what I've always maintained, and I have always told Nikhil also and everyone that, you know, like when this came to me, I did not see ki main kiski kahani bata rahi hu. I simply saw it as a human story of emotions, relationships. No matter what period you are in, the one thing that doesn't change is people and their emotions. So that's all I was focused on in getting that right. So again, it was not about the show and the colors and the costumes and all of that, not to be larger than life. Keep it all subtle, because eventually it's the drama and the emotion that has to win over everyone. And that was the aim.
She's being very modest. Aisa kuch nahi tha. She was fretting over every color and every detail. Aur agar aapka jo dupatta inko jis rang ka jo shade chahiye, agar waisa nahi tha, she would have a heart attack. To aisa kuch nahi, har cheez pe bahut concentrate kar rahi thi.
But sab earthy tones chahiye hote the. Matlab all that. Nothing blingy.
That's so nice. It is, this seriousness is very, very pleasing to the viewer. I really like the fact that you have given so much attention, and I'm looking forward to that. Kunal, I have to first start with congratulating you. You are one of the co-founders of Keto.org, one of the platforms that have done hugely, hugely humongous work in the times of COVID, and it still continues. Thank you for that.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
And you're a licensed pilot. You're also a car rally driver. So you are a physical person, okay? And your very close friend Hrithik did Jodha Akbar. And you spend a lot of time together. Tell me, what are the qualities that you have as a person? How much did you bring to your character? Of course, Babar is a huge, huge feat to accomplish, because we have, I guess, I haven't seen any film on Babar in recent times. One was there probably in the 1940s, but not in the last 60 to 80 years. कैसे शुरुआत की आपने इसकी?
जी, क्वालिटीज तो मिताक्षरा बता सकती है, मैं नहीं बता सकता. लेकिन आई थिंक लाइक वी बीन सेइंग इज दैट द कैरेक्टर इन द बुक इज अ कैरेक्टर दैट इज फिजिकली वेरी स्ट्रांग. एंड आई थिंक जस्ट बाय वर्च्यू ऑफ द फैक्ट दैट आई एम अ बिग बिल्ट गाय, आई एम 6'3", आई एम टॉल, आई एम यू नो फिजिकली आई हैव अ सर्टन प्रेजेंस. आई थिंक दैट मेक्स things very easy in terms of just being cast right. I think that was really important. So I think that came very naturally. I've been actually dying to do something which is in the action space. I've never had a chance to do that. I always either get cast as the poet, or I get cast as the sensitive guy who's had something.
Babar was also a poet.
Is, I know.
Gardner also.
He was a poet as well.
He was a poet as well. But the thing is that's what I find most interesting about this character, is that it's a character of contradictions. So he can be a poet, but he can be a warrior as well. He can be somebody that's physically strong, but can be have moments of vulnerability and emotional weakness. He can be somebody that's an emperor, but has a lot of self-doubt. And those are the things that I found really interesting. And I think as an artist, I've gone through moments of incredible self-doubt. Because, you know, you're so, you're really vulnerable. You know, it's the audience that decides whether you've done a good job or not. And, you know, sometimes you wonder whether you're good enough or not. And that is something that I found very relatable in the character, is that you can externally be successful, but you can still be racked with self-doubt and feel very, very vulnerable at times. And for me, that was the interesting element of the character.
Correct. Now, I want to ask this question to Shabana ji. Shabana ji ki jawab de sakti hai iska. Ab dekhiyega kyun. Shabana ji.
Sawal kya hai?
Ye sawal ye hai ki si Babar was born in Uzbekistan, right? His mortal remains are buried in Kabul. Lesser said about Kabul right now, the better. Aur sab log, and he came kitni baar wahan pe ladai ladne ke baad, he came and defeated Ibrahim Lodi in the Battle of Panipat. Ye kya baat hai Hindustan mein ki puri duniya ke log yahan aake bas gaye, basna chahte the by hook or by crook.
आप खुद हिंदुस्तानी हैं, तो इस सवाल का जवाब तो आप खुद दे सकती हैं. मैं अपने बारे में सिर्फ ये कह सकती हूँ कि मुझे आप दुनिया की किसी भी जगह कुछ दिन के लिए छोड़ दें, वो तो मुझसे बर्दाश्त होता है, लेकिन मैं रह कहीं नहीं सकती, सिर्फ हिंदुस्तान में ही रहती हूँ. तो शायद वही बात होगी इस सवाल का जवाब.
That's true, because when I started reading, I mean, I'm quite intrigued at just the promo, because the 6-part series are such a lengthy description of the empire, such a lengthy description ki main dekhna chahti hu ki aage aur kya. Tell me, Mitakshara, ki aap Sanjay Leela Bhansali ke saaye mein dekha jaye to aapne bahut waqt guzara hai, kuch bhi kahe aap jiski protege hote hain uska asar aa jata hai. And I could, as I told you, I could see a little bit shades of his filmmaking into yours. Did you show it to him? Do you think there is a little bit of him in your work?
Firstly, मतलब अगर आपको दिख रहा है hint, तो it's the biggest compliment for me. अगर अपने गुरु की छाया काम में दिखे तो उससे बड़ी कोई तारीफ नहीं हो सकती है. So, this is something I told him also. Of course, I have shown him something from the show. And the only thing I said is, अब इतने साल आपके साथ रही हूँ तो आप तो झलकोगे ही मेरे काम में.
सही.
So yeah, and I'm
मगर
very proud.
उन्होंने आपकी तारीफ की तो उसको क्यों इतना शर्म के बारे में नहीं करा?
उन्होंने लिखा हाँ, he liked it, and I just hope he's proud of me, and yeah.
Absolutely.
We are all very proud of you.
Definitely yes. But you know, मैंने कोई एक बहुत बड़ी magnum opus film. I don't think I have seen a woman direct it in India. Shabana ji, would you agree with me? What is the difference between a male director and a female director when it comes to a huge, huge set, humongous work? A very lengthy portrayal of characters. How was your experience? I'm sorry. I mean, it's the female director and male director. I also don't agree with assuming it like that. But still, there has to be some perspective from the actors on this.
Well, I think the most that I got from this was Mitakshara never got overwhelmed by the scale. She stayed true to the drama and to the human story. And that, I think, is one of the greatest strengths of the series. I've yet to see all of it together. But I think the fact that she didn't get overwhelmed and she stayed true to the drama and the story is what gives it that special edge, I think.
Okay. And Kunal, I really want to ask you, when you start to prepare for a role such as this, what are the things that you did to yourself? What, like in acting, we were trained, we were told that 80% of the emotion inside, only 20% outside. And you have to emote a lot through your eyes, your lips, your temples, everything. I could see, I mean, there was, you have done something with your voice and the body language that you have. But still, what are the challenges of playing a huge historical towering figure?
Well, I think the biggest challenge, of course, is to understand the time. I think, you know, when you're playing a character from a completely different time, you have to understand what their mindset is, because their likes, their dislikes, you know, what they valued, what they didn't value, what they wanted. Those are things that are very different from what we have now. So I think it's very important to understand the mindset and the world that these characters lived in. And for that, I think what I did was I read a lot of history. I read a lot of books that were based in that time. Fortunately enough, we had Alex Rutherford's book as well, which is very detailed. The yes. script is amazing. You know, the script had so many details that that just gave you insights into that world. So I think that, I think, is the most challenging thing, is to understand and get into that mindset.
All right. And lastly, Shabana ji, what are the signs of a good historical and what are the signs of a bad historical? We've seen a lot of films on historical characters in the last couple of years. What do you like in a historical? If it is well-made, and what makes a good historical well-made?
I think that it gives you such an opportunity to use your imagination in a way where you can just flourish it, you know. But when it is historical, then obviously there are certain boundaries and certain parameters of the times that you have to keep in mind. And yet, it gives you a chance to step into the life of a person whom I've never met in my real life, or I've never understood that time. And I feel very grateful as an actor that I get this opportunity through the parts that I play to inhabit the world of people that I would never meet.
With that personality, obviously you will always get to play the kingmaker, man. Remember that. So thank you so much. Bahut shukriya. Haath kangan ko arsi kya, padhe likhe ko farsi kya, dekh lenge.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.